Hello, everyone. Today, I'm going to show you how to build a Qt application using Visual Studio Code. Here's the application we'll be working on. It's a simple Windows application with two buttons that log some messages when clicked. To setting up the project, let's start by creating a new empty folder for our project and naming it Login Form. Now, let's open VS Code inside this folder. Next, we'll add the necessary files. First main.cpp, next mainwindow.cpp, mainwindow.h, and mainwindow.ui. Before we move forward, we need to install the Qt extension pack in VS Code. Once installed, we need to set the Qt installation path. To do this, first open VS Code command palette. Type Qt and select Register Qt Installation. Choose the folder where Qt is installed. Next, we need to configure the CMake. To do that, let's add a CMakeLists.txt file to our project. I have already created the CMake file, which you can find in my GitHub repository or extract from a Qt Creator project. Just make sure to update the project name to LoginForm in the CMake file. If you're building for other platforms, you can find specific settings in the Qt extension documentation. We need Qt 6.5 or later for this setup. Add an executable with Win32 and macOS bundle. And also our project files. Link Qt Core and Qt widgets. Save the file, and you'll see that VS Code generates build files inside the build folder. Maybe your build files will not generate. Don't worry, I will delete this and show you how to generate the build directories. In main.cpp, we need to set up a simple Qt application window. I have already written the code, so I'll just copy and paste it here. This code is automatically generated when creating a Qt application in Qt Creator. Save all the files and let's create the UI for the application. Right now, the mainwindow.ui file is empty, so let's add some elements. I have already created a basic UI using Qt Designer, so I'll copy and paste the generated code here. Now, our window have some simple Qt widgets and two buttons, OK and Cancel. Before we build, let's delete the existing build folder to start fresh. Open VS Code command palette. Type CMake and select Selector Kit. Select your preferred toolchain. Next, we need to set up the debugger configuration. Create a launch.json file. Select C++, Windows, as the environment. Then select the Windows Visual Studio Debugger configuration. Now, save the file and let VS Code to generate the necessary build directories. Let's build and debug the project. Once the build is finished without errors, the window opens successfully. We can also see that VS Code auto-generates the UI header file for the main window inside the build directory. Now, let's add click events for the buttons. First, we check the button's object name in mainwindow.ui. Then Then, in mainwindow.h, we add a slot functions. In mainwindow.cpp, we implement this function to print message in console. Now, we need to connect the button's click signal to this function. To do that, we use the Qt connect function. This is the OK button from our UI. This refers to the click signal of the button, which gets triggered when the button is clicked. This represents the current class, which is main window in this case. This tells Qt that when the button is clicked, it should call our slot function. So now, whenever the OK button is clicked, our function will execute, and we'll see the log message printed in the console. Let's save the files and build again. Now, when we click the OK button, we can see the log message printed in the debug console. Let's quickly do the same for the cancel button. Now, when we click either button, the messages appear in the console. This is how you can set up and build a Qt project in VS Code. Thank you for watching. If you found this helpful, feel free to like, share, and subscribe for more tutorials.